Hey everyone, this is Eric. I'm here with a new rare video from me. I don't usually go front face on my videos, but this is a new series that I'm going to start. I'm going to start showcasing all of my 1950s appliances in my house. I have my camera set up focused on this General Motors Frigidaire. So you'll see other videos later on where I'm going to show you the whole entire thing of it. You can see the cabinets up here, which will be in another video where I'll showcase the steel appliances that were popular back then. So for today, I'm going to show you how I defrost my old General Motors Frigidaire. So, you can see it has a little freezer compartment up here, and right now it doesn't have a whole lot of ice in it. So I took all my food out and actually turned this off. You're really supposed to put it in the defrost setting, but for this I turned it off today. So this is one of the racks. This is aluminum, gold aluminum, keeps it nice and cold. Put that over here. That'll be clean later. And you have another shelf. I usually break the entire thing down. There's two of these. You won't be able to see the other one because I'll have to move the camera. Not going to do that today. So here's the other one. Then you have at the bottom, you have a drawer, which this is the drawer. I only have one problem with my drawer, considering that this is really old. I have a little hole here from rust, but other than that, the drawer is in really good condition. And I'm not worried about those little problems. And this is the top section for the drawer. And then it's a little shelf. A little crack from being really old, but pretty good shape. Now, because of that hole, sometimes I get a little water down at the bottom. So I put these little pads, puppy pads, but they absorb the water in case any gets under there. But since the last time I did this, no water, so I reused it. So now my Frigidaire is completely empty. Then we have this drawer underneath. I'll also keep one of those little pads in there just to keep it dry, because underneath here it's a little worn out. So I'm gonna keep this again. There's no need to get rid of something if it still can be used. So what I usually do is, you got ice all under here. Usually, sometimes if you hit the light bulb gets loose from opening and closing the door. It's not broke. I usually put the tray in the bottom if the water's going to go down. So how do I get this ice out of here? Well, a lot of people use a hairdryer. A lot of people chisel it out, and that's not good. If you hit the lines in there, all this history is gone. So I have this steamer cleaner. This thing works really good. You don't have to touch, you don't have to crack up any ice or anything. And it works really fast. So might get a little loud in the video, but you'll see what happens and how quick this is. Let me get a little bit of steam. See, I got some steam now. Alright, so I'm gonna start at the bottom and I'm just gonna get all the ice off of every one of them. Just go along the top here. You don't want to puncture anything, you don't want to force anything. Nice and easy. Take your time. Do it like this, and you dump your ice out. Now your bottom's done. I found if you do it in stages, it works better. Now I'm going to work on my sides. Usually everything falls into my tray, but sometimes it don't. So I got this towel here. Clean it up later. Sometimes, because I have a little hand, I can reach in and knock down the little ice that's loose. I won't force nothing. When I get tired of working on that side, I'll move over this side a little bit. Put that, melt that ice. My light bulb again. Bulb just loose. So I'm gonna move this tray up here since the bottom is done. That way the water doesn't. Thank you. less of a mess that way. And there's a coil up in here too, just like on the bottom. So just go along the same way. Tray back down for a second. Just go along each one of these coils. Taking breaks to empty your water every now and then. See, this is much nicer than a hairdryer. A little messy. 1956. I don't know how they did it in 1956. I think they put a pot of water in there and it was an all day thing. I think they have a steam cleaner. Put all that over there. And dump. So I'm going to pause the video for a few and I'm going to finish it up and then you'll see the ending. Okay, I'm back. I'm pretty much done. Key here is once this is all done, I want to make sure it's really dry before I turn it on. The reason I do that is because as soon as this thing kicks, it'll start making ice on it really fast. So I want to clean my fridge really good. If this is on when you're doing this, your towel will stick to it, so that's why I turn it off. Get all this clean. I'm going to work on this light bulb. I didn't want to do it wrong. That's the frosting. All this dry. Now I'm going to work on this light. So this little plate comes off, it's glass. And all I got to do is tighten that bulb a little bit. Just from opening and closing the door, kind of works itself loose a little bit. Take a lot of care to make sure this thing, this Frigidaire, stays nice and clean. Didn't think it was. A lot of work, but it's worth it. I'm gonna take my rag now, clean some of these spots. Dirty. I use these magic erasers. Very light. I don't want to take off any of the anything good, like paint. But just on these marks, works pretty good. Since this Frigidaire is used every day, let's get dirty. I'm going to put it back together again. Put my drawer back in. I'm gonna put my pad back in. Put my pad in. Back. My bottom piece back in the drawer. My drawer is still clean because I didn't put anything in there the last time. I'm gonna put my pad down at the bottom. You're listening to The Standard. iHeartRadio. All of these great songs on one station. This is The Standard on iHeartRadio. I put my pads in so you can't see them. And they got that little blue, kind of like the inside of the thing. So, nobody even knows they're there but me. You have made my life free. Get my trays a wipe down, put my racks back in. Do all this stuff slowly and carefully. No reason to rush. When you rush through a job like this, turns out sloppy. My final piece. All interlocked together, and you can see. The show on the video. From the top. Nice and clean. All the racks. Door, everything is clean. So now, camera fell. My professionals, I'm gonna kick it on. I usually go with the low setting first. Her to kick on. It's always a good thing. And this thing will be very cold in 15 minutes. And put my all my frozen stuff back in. I don't keep a whole lot in here. Keep some stuff up top. You don't want to overload your freezer. That's pretty much it. But thanks for watching me defrost my original General Motors Frigidaire and showcase more of my old appliances in other videos. I thought this was a cool way to show this. I have my thermometer here that I keep back in the corner so I can see how cold my Frigidaire is. So I'm going to load my stuff back in, and thanks for watching. See you.